boring. I should be on stage. Ooh, I missed a spot. Pathetic. I'm getting excited over a mug stain. Gross. It's pear, not apple. I hate pears. I'm Danny.
Rob.
You seem like someone who's got a story, Rob. Actually, don't tell me. It's probably better if you don't. I should get to my other job.
I wonder if she knows that she's the reason I'm here.
I sure hope Ethan gets here on time. I wonder if he's doing all right.
Oh, sorry!
Oh God, this place is huge. How am I supposed to find my train? What if I get lost? I don't belong here. Why did I think I could go alone?
Everything will be all right. Will it, though? Just stick to your 8-year plan like peanut butter. Oh, I should tweet that.
I love you, Lily. It won't be long now.
The day has finally come. I'm seeing my sister after 2 whole years. I hope she hasn't changed too much. I hope it won't be too weird.
Hi there. Welcome to Polar Express, Captain.
Haven't you ever heard of personal space?
thievery in a train station. Very 19th century London pickpocket. Like in all those Charles Dickens books.
I don't have time for this.
Are you an orphan? Are you on the run?
I'm on the run.
Well, sort of. Can you do other cool stuff? Like pick locks? I've always wanted to learn. Oh my gosh. I didn't even notice you take that from me.
So, where are you going?
Oh, I'm not going anywhere. I'm meeting someone.
Cool. I'm going to LA.
Cool.
So what's your name?
Oh, really? We go to the same school. I thought you know me as that trans guy. I'm Corbin.
I'm Quinn. Out of what? 2,000 kids in our school? I barely know anyone. I guess I just usually keep to myself.
My safe place, at last.
I couldn't help but notice that you seem a little jumpy.
What? I'm okay. Is that obvious?
I can help you. Everyone wants to be helped, even though sometimes people believe that they don't need it. My name is Ethan. What's yours?
I'm Iris. It's just, well, if you really want to know. Ethan!
Sorry, miss. I think it's been a mistake.
Miss? Well, I'm not a miss. I'm a sir.
A sir? How does that work?
Well, I identify as guy.
And now I'm going on this trip. This must be a huge mistake. But that's what people do when they graduate, right? Go on big trips and find themselves. I've never even left Vancouver. Honestly, I'd be just as happy to stay at home and live vicariously through Anthony Bourdain. I could stay in bed and never leave.
I believe that deep down you're craving adventure. Otherwise, you wouldn't even be here. There's nothing wrong with wanderlust. This is a growing experience for you.
I guess so. I just feel like I have no idea what I'm doing.
To get what you want, you have to know exactly how much you're willing to give up. You'll do great. Thanks for the chat, but I have to get going now. Corbin!
Ethan!
So good to see you! Is everything okay?
Well, now that you're here, everything's better.
What? Wait, is she a girlfriend or something?
I am his boyfriend. What's it to ya?
Whatever.
Ugh, get away from me! That guy was so insensitive, bumping into me, looking me up and down, and completely refusing to respect that I'm a guy. Asshole.
Maybe he felt under pressure misgendering you. I know I felt that at first, too.
Oh, whatever. Let's just forget about him.
Good idea. I only have an hour till my train leaves to go back home.
Really? I only have an hour with you again?
Yeah. It's the only train I can take without my father noticing that I'm gone.
Okay. Well, I'm still glad we met up.
Me too. Let's get our favorite drinks.
Our regulars, please.
You two look happy.
Hey, you guys notice that he's here a lot lately?
Well, you're noticing him.
What? No? Yes.
Yes, you're a terrible liar. It's healthy to maintain balance in your life. You totally deserve it.
Anyways, have you seen Andrew07's latest post? It's so cool. Hello? Sorry, I just have a quick question. Okay, so the schedule says the 6:30 p.m. train to Toronto arrives at, well, 6:30 p.m. But the national statistic for trains arriving on time is only about 70%. So based on your experience here, at what exact time does the train usually arrive here? Yes, what's around 6:30 EVP? Look, I'm just trying to plan my trip to its maximum efficiency. You know, like how Benjamin Franklin says, by failing to prepare, you're preparing to fail. Actually, that was one of my tweets today. Like on Twitter, the social media app thing. Okay, bye!
What's this?
Nothing.
Didn't look like nothing to me.
This is my guitar pick, just like Kurt Cobain's. Did you just put that in your mouth? Can I have it back? You're not gonna give it back until I show you, are you? It's really nothing special. It's just a song I'm working on. Can I have it back, please? It's embarrassing.
Is it a love song?
Well,
it is, isn't it? No way. Is it for her? The girl who works at the cafe?
Shh. Yes, yes, it's for her. Just be quiet.
Have you asked her on a date or anything yet?
Nope.
Why not?
I don't know. I guess it's just never really the right time.
Never really the right time. Sounds like you've been here for a while.
Yeah, I noticed she always seems busy. But why am I telling you all this?
It's a commercial audition.
Commercial? What?
Batteries. All to help me pave my way in the world. Life of an actress, you know?
You're an actor? That's so cool!
That's so cool!
There was this huge casting call today that I was hoping to go to, but I had to work, so I thought I'd put the costume on anyway.
Quite talented. And you were singing earlier, too. Do you play any instruments?
Not to brag, but check this out.
Come jam with us sometime.
Oh, I'd love to.
Oh, great!
Talk soon!
You can sing too?
Yes.
Really? Really?
No. I'm twisting my hair. My mom could always tell if I was lying if I twisted my hair. Oh, why did I say that? I hate lying. And my face would look guilty. Does my face look guilty? Oh, I only know how to sing Footloose and the bunny rap.
Don't worry. I can help you learn how to sing, if you'd like.
Really? You'd do that?
Yeah, honestly, I'm just learning how to play the guitar and how to sing.
You're so great, though.
Thanks.
This is brilliant. I could learn to sing, that way I wouldn't even be live. Polar Espresso Cafe.
Which direction are you headed?
south to LA.
Fancy that! That's where my grandpa and I are going to before we go to New Orleans. Do you have family down that way?
You could say that.
Mysterious. I like it. Come on, tell me, what's in LA? Oh. I understand. Talking about stuff can be hard. It's okay. I spilled the ashes.
What?
Yeah. We had our train tickets booked and everything. Then he got sick. Too sick to travel. He pulled me in really close. He could barely talk, his lungs were so weak. And he said, Margo, take me to New Orleans, no matter what. So, I'm taking him. My grandpa will always be the most important person to me. You know, I used to spend so much time trying to fit in. I wanted to be, quote unquote, normal. Kids in the schoolyard would laugh at what I wore or how I did my hair. I changed to act and talk and dress like everyone else. My grandpa came to me one day, leaned down on one knee, and said, you cannot try to be what others want you to be, because your most beautiful feature is your spirit. And when you try to bend to conform, the life drains from your eyes. I realized he was right. I couldn't try to be anyone else. I just had to be the best me that I could.
She seems a bit like my sister. She would have been 17 today.
Would have been? I'm so sorry.
When I was about 6, I remember falling in this really funny way. My whole entire family started laughing at me. My mom, my dad, and even Lily, my sister. Except while she was laughing at me, she helped me up. When I asked her why, she said, Quinn, you and I are sisters. Every single time you fall down, I will always be there to pick you up. As soon as I finished laughing, she always knew exactly what to say.
She sounds amazing.
She is, was, you know, it's so hard waking up every single morning and realizing she's gone. Having to remind myself, I don't have a sister anymore. She's gone. I guess I still haven't processed it. I don't have a sister anymore.
Yeah, it hasn't really hit me yet either. I don't think I ever realized how final it all is. Death. It's permanent. He's gone. This was all just fun and games, you know? An adventure. How exciting to run away from home with only a credit card and a destination. But holy crap, he's actually dead.
It's okay to be sad.
Thank you.
For what?
You're the first person who told me I was allowed to be sad.
Your attention, please. Due to extreme weather conditions, there are power outages throughout the city. Some of the cell phone towers are down. All trains have stopped on their tracks. We have our emergency generators operating the heat and servicing the Polar Espresso Cafe. Please stand by for further notification.
I'm so sorry. We'll be ready in just a minute. Medium hot chocolate, no whip. Thanks for waiting. The napkin's right over here. Help yourself. Can I help the next customer, please?
Sorry, but is my espresso ready?
fine, really. I'll survive. I don't like this. I need some water.
I'll get you some.
I need to get out of the dark.
Watch it! Bear with me. I'm not the best at handling these things. What's your name?
Alex. What's yours?
Luther. What's wrong?
The dark. I'm scared of the dark.
It's nothing but shadows.
Exactly. Shadows. Things jumping out at you. Worse than that, being alone.
You're not alone, though. She's there, and I guess I'm here. So how can you be alone?
Well, obviously I'm not physically alone. But mentally. Mentally, I feel like I am.
So you're saying you feel that there's no one to help you, no matter who's around you.
Exactly. I guess you felt that before.
Well, yes, you say I'm used to the dark. Have been for a while, actually.
I know I am.
So how do we get used to it?
Well, you shouldn't. Okay, what you should do is find a lantern or a light. Just something good in your life, something bright. And use that to burn away the shadows while it's warmth and it's light, the goodness, you know. Okay, but if you don't find that light soon enough, you do eventually get used to the dark and become reluctant to leave. Anyways, look, I really should be going now.
This is the worst. My train's gonna be late, and then my father's going to... I need to get home.
Well, Ethan, from what you've told me about your father, I actually think that it's good that you're away from home right now.
Yeah. At least I get to spend more time with you.
This is a crisis! A full-fledged national emergency! My phone isn't working! Possibly borrow your phone? Just momentarily, please?
Sure, just a sec.
Oh my goodness, thank you so much.
All right. Oh. Oh. What the? My phone isn't working either.
Neither is mine. We're virtually disconnected.
This can't be happening. This absolutely, positively cannot be happening right now.
I know, right? This is just awful.
They're just phones, not our lives. Let's calm down and relax.
Are you kidding? How can we stay calm and relaxed at a time like this?
Yeah, my meditation app is on my phone.
I haven't finished checking my subreddit.
Yeah, and I haven't even finished scrolling through my Tumblr feed. And my perfect schedule has been completely ruined. All right, plan D. I'm gonna go to the front desk and see if they have a backup phone I could borrow.
This is a song I created that helps me when I feel sad.
It's okay.
smile.
I like your song. Thanks. What's the other language you were singing in?
Japanese. I recently moved here from Japan, a few months ago.
Oh, cool. I speak another language as well. French. I sing too.
You do?
Yeah. So, how come you moved all the way over here from Japan?
Well, my parents got a divorce. My mom, brother, and I moved here to get a fresh start.
Oh, that's good you are with your brother and your mother.
Yeah, it's good we are together.
Your singing is beautiful, and it's amazing you wrote that song.
Writing and singing helps me to express myself. I have trouble talking about my parents' divorce and what I'm going through, even if I found the words to talk about it with my mom. She'll just remember my father, and she doesn't want to remember him. So, I think.
People have told me that singing is therapeutic.
Yeah, I love singing, and I love singing here. This is where I was inspired to write this song. My dream is to make a record and tour everywhere.
That's so great. Maybe we could write a song together.
I would like that. I've been writing a song for my dad. I want him to understand how I feel. Would you like to help me with it?
I'd like that. This is a disaster. They're gonna freak out if I don't call.
Who's gonna freak out?
My parents. Usually I don't mind calling them so much, but with my phone missing, it's been exhausting running around trying to wait to call them, and now with the power outage.
Do you check in with them pretty often?
Mm-hmm. Either I call them or they call me every 2 hours or so they know I'm safe.
Trust me, it'll be fine. I have plenty of experience dealing with the helicopter parents.
Helicopter parents?
You know, those parents who hover over their kids, constantly looking out for them, even when it's not necessary.
Yeah, that's them. I guess I'm used to it. You could call me a helicopter daughter. So you work for a travel agency too? Danielle?
Oops, wrong name tag. Call me Dan. And yep, unfortunately I work there as well.
Unfortunately? Is it not a very good place?
No, it's a great place. Probably one of the best. My family actually owns it.
You don't like working with them?
No, it's just not exactly the place for me. Sitting and staring at a computer screen all day, booking these fabulous vacations for other people, it's a little depressing. What about you?
So what is the place for you then?
The stage, definitely.
Oh, you act, that's so cool. Are you gonna pursue it?
I'm actually saving up for school right now. That's why I'm working two jobs.
Yeah, I hear school can be pretty expensive.
Tell me about it. My parents aren't exactly too thrilled about me spending so much money on some acting school when I could just continue working at the family business. What about you? Are you traveling somewhere? Or?
Yeah, I'm taking a small trip down the coast.
And your parents are cool with it?
Not at first. I had to convince them. I thought it would be good for me.
Good on you. You gotta live a little. Face your fears, you know?
Yeah, I guess I just need to get comfortable with the world. Thanks, Danny.
Anytime. Here, on the house. I am totally posting this on Instagram.
Do you wanna? We could both. So, when the trains start running again, where are you going?
Oh, I'm going to Toronto. To visit the University of Toronto, because I'm planning on attending next year. It's all part of my 8-year plan to become an actuary. It's actually one of the fastest growing fields, you know, and they say that I'm Mia, by the way.
Iris.
And Miss Mia 01 on Twitter. I tweet inspirational quotes with these gorgeous landscapes in the background.
You really should follow me. I will if I ever find my phone.
Remember? It's okay, it's okay. Everything would believe me, I know. know how crucial a phone can be just to keep in touch with everyone. I mean, mine is so intertwined with my life. Seriously, it has my planner on it, and that literally is every detail of my life for the next 2 years. And all my notes and photos, and don't even get me started on my apps. This isn't helping, right? Look, you can do this. It's just a phone. I mean, well, phones are important, especially now with power outage and everything. Once you establish a plan B, everything will be all right. I think. My grandpa loved power outages like this. We used to have fake ones all the time. We'd turn off all the lights in the house and cover the little red flashing lights on the clocks and TV with cloths. We'd light candles and sit together. He'd tell stories about when he was growing up. And we'd play the xylophone together. But not anymore. I want to believe that he's still with me. And I mean, he is. Like, his ashes are in this jar. But, like, he's not really here.
I can't imagine if I lost my grandma. She means a lot to me. She always tells me stories of growing up with her Squamish heritage. Light the sage to cleanse the roof from negativity, and also to share kindness to the earth that we stand on. It sounds like you're really close with him, and it's important to have family like that. You okay?
It's just that everyone idolizes this notion that the people we're related to are supposed to love us and care for us unconditionally, but sometimes the people who are supposed to be there for you aren't. I spend all my time here at the train station because whenever I'm at home, my mom and I are always fighting about everything. My grades, my friends, my musical aspirations. So here I am.
I think that the relationships we make ourselves and the people who we choose to care for and love can be the same or sometimes even stronger than family bonds. The people who we choose to surround ourselves with, they are our family.
Very apron-y.
Sorry, what?
This has been great, albeit somewhat terrifying. I mean, you should follow me on Twitter. Okay, bye.
Mia?
Yeah?
Are you trying to avoid me?
What? No, of course not. Okay, maybe a little. But it's not you.
It's not? Then what is it?
I'm not quite sure how to explain it. It's just that I'm better online. I mean, when I talk to real people in real life, in real time, I'm not concise or poised, well, except with plans. But I just ramble on and on, and I say nonsensical things like, aprony, apron. I can feel this awkwardness seeping from me like some sort of fog machine. You know, like the ones at the haunted house. See, I'm doing it again. And it's just so much cleaner online. I can edit. I can double check my words before I say it. I can even make it Swedish. I can be anything I want.
Trust me, I totally get that it's way easier online, but it's okay to be awkward. Look at me. Think about it. The imperfect things in life make it the chaotic, fun, bubbling mess that it is.
I guess you have a point. I mean, I'm not exactly on board with that messy part. But this is nice, right? This is okay. I'm doing okay.
Uncle James, hey, I'm at the train station, but the guy at the ticket booth, well, he didn't have my ticket, so didn't you? You didn't get me a ticket. No, I understand. Family means nothing to you. All you give a shit about is your clients and your business. No, I trusted you, okay? You haven't changed!
Hey, you okay?
Leave me alone.
I just want to help.
I don't want your help. How about this? You stay here, I go that way, we don't deal with each other again, all right?
Your anger harms you more than anyone else.
If you want to be helpful, go back to that girl trying to be a guy and leave me alone.
I am not trying to be a guy. I am a guy.
It doesn't even matter, because people will always view you as a girl. Even my opinion does change. The world hasn't, miss.
You still don't get it, do you? My biological sex does not determine how I express myself with my gender. My gender and sex are two different components of what makes me. My gender is how I identify, and my sex is how I was assigned at birth, and hopefully one day I can do something about that. Oh, and how does one feel like that, you may ask yourself? Well, this is something I always knew. Anyways, I hope I've cleared up the situation so that there are no further screw-ups.
It's okay to feel envy. I once drowned in hatred and envied everyone who was happy too.
You don't know what you are talking about. You can never understand what I have been through, never. So shut up and get the hell away from me before someone gets hurt!
Ethan, what's wrong?
Oh, look at you. Look how weak you are. How could you help me or anybody else when you can't even help yourself? You're pathetic.
Shut up! You don't know anything about me!
Thank you.
father. He reminded me of my father. For years, he would take my mom's hard-earned money and spend it on nights of gambling, drinking, and even drugs. When he's home, he would find the littlest things to argue about. And he would speak with his fists sometimes. And I would take the brunt of it. My mom says I am not allowed to feel hatred or resentment because I must understand and respect him as my dad.
Understand him? That's not your job. His job is to take care of you.
Look, I know you don't know me, but how can you even think of helping others when you have been living with that?
That's how I feel better. When you express what's really on the inside, but people let it slip by, you learn to keep it to yourself, with the belief that nobody cares about you.
He cares for you. That's plain to see.
Yeah, that's true.
And then that stupid boy talked to you like that.
No one ever provoked that anger inside of me before. Well, except for my father, but I was never able to express it.
You don't deserve that.
Why'd you go and have to talk to him that way?
I wanted to prove a point.
You can't just be mean and push people to their limits when you want to prove a point.
Didn't you see him running around acting like some hero? Like he has the solutions to all of our problems when he doesn't even know how to solve his own.
You don't know what he's going through.
And you don't know what I'm going through either.
Fine. I guess you're right. I don't.
I just need to get the hell away from all of you and just maybe try to write something.
How can he be a writer with such a negative outlook? Maybe he should take some tips from Android 07.
Android 07? Wait, what's your Tumblr username?
It's HappinessJPEG, why do you ask?
You began following him 2 months ago after he wrote Truth Within Darkness.
How did you know that?
Because it turns out I can be a good writer with a negative outlook.
Wait, what? He's Android 07? Are you kidding me? How can he be so great online and so terrible in person?
I can't believe I thought he was the one person without an online persona.
Well, I guess no one can really know what someone else is going through. What they're really feeling inside.
Yeah, I guess. Even Android 07.
Hey, Corbin. I really appreciate you talking to me what you're going through as a transgender guy.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I guess some people just don't understand. Well, then I mean, some people do understand, still don't accept it.
Well, it's good that your family and friends accept you.
Yeah, I guess. My parents accept me. Well, I mean, my mom wonders if it's just a phase, but she's still supportive. Ethan accepts me. My friends online accept me, and that's actually how Ethan and I met, online. However, I can't exactly say that the so-called friends I have at school are really even my friends. I'm just their token minority friends so they can look like they care, even though they really don't. It's either man up, Corbin, or wow, Corbin, you look like such a lesbian today. I can never win.
I'm sorry I have to go through that. It must really hurt.
Yeah. Hey, are you okay?
Yeah. I guess I just miss my sister.
I miss mine too.
Sorry.
I'm just thinking about my sister.
I'm going to visit her today. I haven't seen her in about 2 years. I don't know whether to be excited or scared or both.
Probably scared.
What?
Just thinking out loud. I have an older brother who can be so inconsiderate.
Well, that definitely doesn't apply to my sister. She was probably the most amazing person in this world.
Where is she?
She died. I'm going to visit her gravesite.
I'm sorry to hear that.
That's so sad. You know, in French, I miss you. Translates back to you are missing from me. Tu me manques.
That's beautiful. I'm glad I'm going to where our ashes are buried. I really wanted to visit her on the anniversary of her death. I'm so glad my parents were so supportive in actually making this trip happen.
That's good. I'm thankful my brother is with my mom and I don't feel as alone as I might. If it was just my mom and I, she works so hard to support us, and I hardly see her.
I felt pretty alone after my sister and I were split up. I isolated myself. It was scary. I lost so many friends, so many people I cared about. I even found it hard talking to my sister on the phone. At least I have a counselor, like, that helps me.
That's good that counseling helps you.
Yeah, social workers have helped me and my sister. Even though we don't see each other often, at least we're safe. My sister lives with our aunt, and I live with her grandma.
Ethan, I'm worried about you going back home. You need to be safe.
I agree. I heard what you were saying earlier about your father, and you don't deserve that kind of awful treatment from him. Some adults use their intimidating parts of themselves to show young people who's boss, and it's not fair.
It's just, sometimes I see how he is wounded from his own childhood, and I have to be empathetic.
It's not up to you to raise your father, Ethan. Maybe you should see a counselor.
I don't know. I'm just scared about making things worse for my family.
Sounds like things can't get worse. The rights of gay people are about being protected and treated with love and care.
Hello, Polar Special Cafe?
Yeah.
Iris? Hello?
Mom, you found me! Good investigating! Yes, I'm okay. No, the power stopped, so I'm still here. No, I don't want to come back home. I'll call you soon. Bye. They may not be perfect, but I'm glad I've got the parents I do. I don't know what I'd do without them.
It's great that you have caring parents. You know, it's actually pretty cool we've all met and got to know one another. Grandmother always tells me in her Squamish words, at me she you well. When we share kindness and the truth of who we are community. And that direct translation means we are family.
We are family. I like that, you know? I've been thinking back to what Alex said earlier with the French translation missing from me, and I realized that you are what's missing from me, Danny.
That's right. Missing from me. Tu me manques.
In Japanese, we say, Anata nashi ja watashi wa kanpeki ja nai.
In Mongolian, we say, Chiba nata sotte tichben.
In Serbian, it's Tisio nashi da sto mene.
In Cantonese, we say, Ohogwa jime.
In Arabic, it is Konfe dat anan budi min me.
In German, we say, Si bon mir velen.
Love,
now commence for the trains traveling to Toronto, Seattle, San Francisco, and Los Angeles. Thank you.
My phone is working again. Quick, let's call yours before it gets too busy.
Finally.
Okay, you need a better password. 1, 2, 3, 4, just on the count it.
I never thought I'd see you again!
Oh no! The screen's cracked.
I dropped it.
Well, that sucks. But at least you returned it. I'm just so happy to finally have it back. Thanks for all your help, Mia.
No problem. And if you want, I can lend you a screen protector. It'll fill in all the cracks in your phone and prevent new ones. It's amazing.
Thanks, but I think I'll leave the cracks for a while. Just to remind myself of all this and what's really important. Have fun on your tour.
Thanks. Have an efficient trip. I mean, have fun. Bye. Bye, everyone. Oh, everyone follow me on Twitter. I left my info with Danny.
Bye.
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 What? All I did was take your phone. Okay, and maybe a couple of bucks.
What? Oh,
thanks for your help.
You might be really good at stealing things, but no one deserves to be stolen from.
No kidding.
Goodbye. Oh, I almost forgot.
You owe me something.
Sorry for taking your phone.
Thank you, Luther. You're forgiven. Mom, my phone's charged. I'm so excited. My train's here. It was nice meeting you. Thank you for everything.
Let's keep in touch.
Have a safe trip, Quinn.
Thanks. I'll see you when I get back.
Sure thing.
I don't like to look at my own sadness either.
At least you have your family. My parents died when I was real young. I grew up in group homes, foster homes, the works. It didn't work out well, so in between transitions, I just said, screw it, and took off. All I have is me, some friends, and I had my uncle.
That must be hard. I know that loneliness, that darkness. If we met under different circumstances, we could have been friends. And maybe we still can.
Friends? Oh no. Okay, look, be selfish. Don't get on that train.
I don't know about that.
Well, if you do, be honest with your mom. Sorry for being an asshole earlier, okay? Good luck.
You too. Thanks for meeting me on such last minute notice.
Sure. Anytime.
Thanks for everything. I love you, Corbin. Wish me luck, okay?
I love you too, Ethan. Please be safe.
I'll try. It's my mom. She's wondering where I am.
Ethan, save me a seat. I'm coming with you.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I figured I could help you talk to your mom about how your dad is really affecting you and that you want to go see a counselor. You know, it's okay to ask for help.
I'm not used to asking for help.
Well, from what you've said about the physical violence, I do think it's your mom's legal obligation to do something about this. You can do it. And I'll be there to support you the whole way.
I don't know. Well, actually, I can't imagine doing this, knowing that I have your support. Maybe we can do this together. Let's go. Bye, everyone.
Bye. Bye.
Go give this to him.
Me?
Well, I can't. What if he ends up falling in love with me and then writing me a song?
Yeah, we can't let that happen.
Here, well, you might be hungry.
Thanks.
Polar Espresso Cafe? Luther?
Hmm?
Phone's for you.
Thanks. Hello? Uncle James. Yeah, I know I was pissed off with you earlier. I couldn't believe you didn't get me the train ticket to come and stay with you. I thought you were gonna help me out. Wait, what? New plan. You're trying to get your job transferred out here? Why would you? No, okay. I guess I could help you look for an apartment out here. Yeah. I'll meet you here tomorrow, okay? Bye. Okay, he said that he's trying to get a job transferred out here and that he wants me to come and stay with him. Why do I want to trust him?
Because maybe he's your lantern. You're light.
Polar Espresso Cafe? Yep, hold on a sec. Danny?
That's me!
This is Danny speaking. Oh, the casting call got postponed until tomorrow? Because of the storm? Yeah, I can make it. Wait, the casting director saw Mia's video of mine in the bunny suit? And he wants to make sure that I attend the call? I'd love to. All right, see you then. You cover my shift?
Yes.
You know, it's been hard dealing with my family, learning to play the guitar, but you make it all worthwhile.